Welcome to my channel. If you like my videos, then kindly subscribe, like and watch. Thank you.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear friends, today we are going to cover the part 4 of chapter number 7, that is transformation of stress and strain. So in today's lecture, we will discuss general state of stress. Then we will discuss Mohr circle to the three-dimensional analysis of stress. Then we have certain cases, how to draw the Mohr circle for three-dimensional state of stress. And then we will see a problem as well in order to have a clear understanding of how to draw Mohr circle for three-dimensional state of stress. So let's start with the general state of stress. So as you know that if you have a cube, clear, having state of stress, that is, let's say sigma x in this direction, sigma y is in this direction, and similarly shear stress tau of xy. Similarly, this is tau of x, y. So, this is the state of stress, and this state of stress is plane state of stress, because sigma z is equal to 0, tau of xz is equal to, tau of xz is equal to 0, tau of yz is equal to 0. So, this is a plane stress problem. So we have discussed the plane stress problem and how to draw the Mohr circle. Now we will move toward three-dimensional state of stress. So again, if we have an element clear and that is subjected to three-dimensional stress, sigma x clear, sigma y, and now there is sigma z in z direction as well, as and we have shear force tau of xy, tau of yx, this is yx, this is similarly all the normal stresses and shear stresses are represented. So if you cut this cube at 45 degrees, clear, so it will be a tetrahedron, clear. Now after cutting this cubic elements, the tetrahedron is shown over here. Let me show the things. The remaining things are similar, and we will analyze it in the same manner as that we did it in previous. Clear? So you can see. Let me show you that if you see, this is the tetrahedron. This area is delta A. And remaining the same forces are shown. The normal, this is the normal force in x direction, this is in y direction, and this, these are the shear forces that is acting. Now this area, the axis perpendicular to this area is, this is n. So we will determine the transform stress, that is sigma n, clear. And you have to resolve all these forces into its component, and then we'll apply the equilibrium condition. I will not do this part because it will take too much time. The idea is same that we discussed in the start of chapter number 7. So if you have a general state of stress that is represented by three-dimensional forces, clear, so state of stress at a point Q, let this is point Q, so the state of stress at point Q is defined by delta sigma x, sigma y, sigma z, tau of xy, tau of yz, and tau of zx, clear. So you will resolve them into its component, and it will also include the direction cosine as well. Now what are the direction cosine? Delta x is the cosine of angle which is making with the x-axis, delta y is the cosine of angle which is with the y-axis, and delta y is z is the cosine of angle with the z-axis. So if you apply this equilibrium condition by using this figure or the force analysis, so you will get the same equation, just like in our two-dimensional state of stress problem, that is sigma x dash is equal to sigma x cos square theta. So you will get the same, but here the delta represent the cosine angle, clear? So you will get the transform stress, the equation of transform stress is sigma n is equal to sigma x lambda x square plus sigma y lambda y square plus sigma z lambda z square plus 2 top xy lambda x into lambda y plus 2 top yz into lambda y into lambda z plus 2 top zx is equal to lambda z into lambda x. So this is the transform state of stress, clear, for three dimensional state of stress. Now if we talk about principal stresses, so you know that principal stresses are maximum stresses and minimum stresses. So principal stresses are those stresses which occur in principal plane and where there is no shear force. So shear force is equal to zero in principal plane. So if we focus our mind to the principal stresses, so definitely this term and this term become zero because there will be no shear force in principal plane. So this transformation transform stress will be equal to sigma n is equal to sigma a lambda a sigma b into lambda b square plus sigma c into lambda c square, where sigma a will be equal to sigma n, sigma y will be equal to this will be the principal stress in x direction, this will be the principal stress in y direction, and this will be the sigma z will be the principal become equal to sigma c, which is the principal stress in c direction, and there is no shear force in principal plane. So this normal stress, transform normal stress, is equal to this equation. So these are the principal stresses that occur in principal plane, and they have already, if you rotate this element through angle, what will be the angle? That is theta p. So if you rotate this element to theta p, so all the stresses, normal stresses or principal stresses, is shown, that is in this direction sigma a, this is in sigma b, and this is in sigma z, where sigma c is the principal stress in z direction, sigma b is the principal stress in y direction, and sigma a is the principal stress in a direction, clear? So these are the principal axes and principal plane, and the normal stresses are the principal stresses. Now we will move toward the next topic, that is how to draw our application of Mohr circle for three-dimensional state of stress. So in previous slide you can see we have three principal stresses, that is sigma a, sigma b, and sigma c. So again you will be having x-axis and y-axis. On x-axis you have to draw the normal stresses, or on x-axis we have normal stresses, and on y-axis we have shear stresses. And again, if you move on line x, or if you move on x-axis, so there will be normal stresses that are the principal stresses, but there is no shear stress. And if you move on this line, so there will be only shear stresses, but there will be no normal stresses. So again, from our previous slide, we have sigma a, we have sigma b, and we have sigma c. So if you look at all the three points, let's say this point a is at this point, this is sigma a, at point b we have sigma b, and at point c we have sigma c. Now the most of the student will ask how we have taken these points. So it will be clear to you in a while, where we will discuss some scenarios. So let this is sigma a, at point a the stress is sigma a, and at point b stress is sigma b, and at point c is stress sigma c. Now Mohr circle for three dimensional analysis include three circle. Clear? It is not a three-dimensional circle, but this is the circle that shows you three different circle. Each circle represents a certain plane. How you will determine? Let's talk about this. Clear? So you can see you have identified sigma A, sigma B, and sigma C. So you will have the circle between A and B will be this circle. Clear? The circle between stress B and C will be this, and the circle between A and C will be this. Now, the circle between A and B represent one plane, clear? That is a XY plane, clear? The circle between B and C is a YZ plane, and the circle between A and C represent XZ plane. How do you know? Because you know this A is the principal stress along X-axis, B is the principal stress along Y-axis. So this circle represents the more circle for XY plane. Similarly, B Y plane, Y-axis and C Z-axis. So this circle represents the more stress transformation along YZ plane. And similarly, the largest circle is the stress transformation for the plane XZ. Clear? Okay. So if you plot this circle, remember that each of these circles will be tangent to another circle. So you can see at point A, this circle is tangent to this circle. Now this circle is tangent to this circle, and this circle is tangent to this outer circle. So each of the circle will be tangent to another circle. Clear? Just like in our previous lecture, that in which we have a plane state of stress where there is no stress in Z direction, we also discuss there how to draw Mohr circle for that. So in that you identify sigma A and sigma B, and then you draw a circle. Clear? Let's say this was your point A, that is sigma A or sigma maximum, and this is your point B, that is sigma minimum. Now in this case, we have told you that in this plane state of stress, sigma Z is equal to zero. Clear? So definitely maximum normal stress or the principal stress along Z direction will be also zero. So definitely this will be the point where sigma C is equal to zero. Clear? This is the shear force. So now between B and C, we can also draw a circle. Clear? And similarly, from A to C, we can also draw a circle. So we have represented this plane state of stress to the Mohr circle of three-dimensional analysis of stress. This is a two-dimensional state of stress, but we have to represent it on Mohr circle for three-dimensional stress analysis, because you will see in coming slides or in coming lecture that they will give you the two-dimensional state of stress and they will ask you to draw three-dimensional Mohr circle. So it is very necessary to have a clear idea about this. Clear? Now we will move toward our basic topic. So you can see you have represented this state of stress, three-dimensional state of stress into Mohr circle. So in this case, sigma A is the maximum stress, clear? Sigma C is the minimum stress, and the maximum shearing stress, tau max, that will be taken as the largest radius of the largest circle, and radius of largest circle is this one. Clear? That is why it is taken as tau maximum. So in this case, tau maximum will be equal to sigma max minus sigma minimum divided by 2. I will write over here, tau max will be equal to sigma max minus sigma minimum divided by 2. You can see over here, this is sigma max. When you subtract sigma minimum, the distance will be this, and if you divide by 2, you will get the radius. So in this case, the tau max will be the radius of the largest circle. Clear? So the three circle represent the normal and shearing stress for the rotation around each principal stresses. So initially we plotted only the normal stresses and we draw the circle. So if you rotate the element further, so it will be the at every point you will get a state of stress. Clear? So the shear stress will be maximum at this point, and this shear stress is equal to maximum shear stress is equal to half of sigma max minus sigma minimum. Okay, now we will discuss certain scenario in which we will be having we will discuss how we have taken this sigma A, sigma B and sigma C. Just like in earlier I have told you that how do you know that where this point lies. Clear? So I will clear that query as well. So we can have a situation where for a plane state of stress, we can have a situation in which this is the situation, for example. So you can see sigma x is positive, sigma y is compressive, and tau of xy. So in this case, we can have sigma 1 is positive value, clear? Or any situation in which you get maximum, sigma maximum is positive and sigma minimum is negative. If you have solved the problems, you will get know that we can have principal stresses. That is the case is that you have one principal stress as positive and the second one is negative. So in that criteria, if you plot that, so you will get, if you locate sigma A which is positive, clear? So this is sigma A or sigma maximum, clear? And if you plot sigma B which is minimum or negative, clear? So this is sigma B, clear? So again, for two dimensional state of stress, you have to draw the Mohr circle, and this circle will be this one. Clear? Now in this scenario, there is sigma z is equal to 0. Clear? So if sigma z is equal to 0, it means sigma c normal stress along z direction will be 0. So if you look at sigma c, let this point is sigma c. So sigma a, sigma b and sigma c is equal to 0. So you will draw a Mohr circle or a dotted circle between point A and C, clear, in this manner. And again, you have to draw a circle, dotted circle between point B and this point C. Now, this circle is, if I remove or if I clear it, so you can see one circle is solid and the remaining two circles are dotted circle. So basically, this solid circle represent the state of stress that is given in XY plane, clear? And the remaining two circle are dotted circle. These are the Mohr circle for other planes, other than XY planes. So this is, that's why we call this circle as in plane circle, in plane Mohr circle, clear? And this remaining two dotted circles are known as outplane circle, clear? So the again, the shear stress, you from this figure you can see the maximum shear stress is the shear stress for the largest circle, so it will be this one, and this shear stress is known as maximum shear stress, and that is maximum in plane shear stress, clear? We can also have a shear stress for these. You can see this is the shear stress. But this is the shear stress. I will write it. This is the shear stress. This will be the shear stress, but it will be out plane, out of plane. Out of plane means it is acting in a plane other than XY. Similarly, we can also have a shear stress over here. But remember that you will take the shear stress that is radius of the larger circle. Clear? So again, so if you join them, clear, if you join them, you will get sigma A, sigma B and sigma C, and this is the representation of plane stress problem by using Mohr circle or three dimensional analysis. Clear? So if point A and B are on opposite side of the origin, so this is the first case, is that if point A and B are in opposite direction, so the corresponding principal stresses are maximum and minimum normal stresses. So sigma A and sigma B will be maximum and minimum normal stresses, and maximum shearing stress is equal to the maximum in plane shearing. So remember, this is in plane shearing stress because it is the solid circle, and these are the shear stress, but they are not in plane, they are out of plane. Clear? And the angle maximum plane of shearing stress are 45 degree, that we have discussed previously, that the angle between the principal plane and shear plane is 45 degree, but in Mohr circle you have to take two times of the angle. So you can see this is the principal plane, and if this is the shear plane, so the angle between them is 90 degrees. So if you divide it by 2, so it will be 45 degree angle. Clear? So you can see the these stresses are represented as sigma A and sigma B, and these are the principal stresses, and the angle through which it is rotated, that is theta P. Clear? Okay, so let's move further. Now there is another scenario. Another scenario is that if both A and B are on same side, either on this side or on this side. So in this case, if you plot point A and point B, so in this case you can see that if you draw the circle, it will be a solid circle. Clear? And in the sigma C is, as sigma C is equal to 0, so it will be point here. So you have to draw a dotted circle between point B and C. Similarly, a dotted circle between point A and C. Clear? Now, from this figure, the principal stresses will be sigma A and sigma B. You can also find them. If you haven't any value, you can first solve that to find out sigma A and B, and then you will use this diagram to find out the maximum shear stress. Now in this condition, you can see that maximum shear stress is the radius of the largest circle, but here you can see this shear stress is maximum and this is out of plane. So if you have been asked to find the maximum shear stress for in plane, so then you will take this. Clear? But if you haven't asked about in plane or out plane, so definitely the maximum shear stress will be this one, and this one is the value of this tau max is half of sigma A. How? Because you know that this is sigma A and this is zero, so this tau max is equal to sigma A minus sigma C divided by 2, which will give you this radius or this radius. Clear? So sigma C is equal to 0, so that will be sigma A minus 0 is sigma A divided by 2, and this is the maximum shear stress, but it is out of plane shear stress. Clear? Okay, so what if you have been asked to find the maximum shear stress for in plane, so it will be this one. Clear? And this shear stress, this is the shear stress for in plane, tau max for in plane shear. So this in plane shear can be find out, let me write in plane, that will be equal to sigma a is this distance from this point to this, minus sigma b. Clear? So sigma a minus sigma b, or sigma maximum minus sigma minimum divided by 2. So this distance is sigma a minus sigma b divided by 2. So again, if this is the radius, so this is also the radius. Clear? So if A and B are on the same side of the origin, then circle defining sigma max and minimum and tau max for element is not the circle corresponding to transformation within the plane of stress. And again, maximum shearing stress of element is equal to half of the maximum stress, and the maximum plane angle is 45 degree. Now we will solve some sample problems in order to have a further clear understanding of how to draw Mohr circle for plane stress problem. Clear? So let's move further. Okay, so let's move to concept application problem, that is 7.3. The statement is that for the state of plane stress as in shown, determine the principal planes, principal stresses and maximum shearing stress. So we have to draw three principal planes and principal stresses. So basically you can see you have to find in part A, you have to find sigma A, you have to find sigma B, and you have to find sigma C. Also principal plane theta P is to be find out, and in part B maximum shearing stress. Clear? So you can see from the state of plane stress, the sigma x is given as 6 KSI, so that is 6 KSI. Sigma y is equal to 3.5 KSI, and tau of xy is again, this is the tau of xy. Clear? So you can see this is positive, the x is in positive but force is in negative direction, so that is minus this value 3 KSI. So again, for drawing Mohr circle, because we are talking about three principal stresses, so definitely we have to draw the Mohr circle, and it is very easy to solve it by using Mohr circle, because it do not require the memorization of the formula. So simple trigonometric ratios are applied. Clear? So let's start with it. As you know that for drawing Mohr circle, you must draw the x-axis representing normal stresses and y-axis representing the shear stresses. And for drawing the Mohr circle, we have to plot x point and y point. X point is sigma x comma minus tau of xy. Similarly, y point is sigma y comma tau of xy. Again, so if for x point, this x point is equal to 6 KSI, 6 comma minus and minus 3 plus 3, so 6 comma 3. And this y point is 3.5, which is sigma y, so 3.5 comma minus 3 KSI. So again, if you locate point 6 comma 3, so you can see that this is the point 6, this is from x axis it is taken as 6, and at y distance this point is 3. Clear? So this x is 6 comma 3. And similarly, when you plot minus 3.5, so it will be this point. So y is 3.5 minus 3. So 3.5 is in positive direction and minus 3 is in negative. So this distance is minus 3. Clear? So when you join them, these point x and y, so it will intersect the horizontal axis at point C. So this will be the center. Clear? So center will having the coordinate sigma average comma 0, as you know. And sigma average is sigma average is equal to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2. Clear? And that is sigma x is 6 plus sigma y is 3.5 divided by 2. Clear? And that will, sigma average will be equal to 4.75 KSI. Clear? That is this point. Sorry, I have flu. That's why I have certain problem. Okay, so when you join this point with Y, it will intersect at point C. Now this CX is horizontal axis or X axis, and this CY represent vertical axis or Y axis. Clear? So this is state of stress. But when you want to find the principal stresses, because sigma A, and it is given that you have to find the three principal stresses. So sigma, you have to find the sigma A, sigma B, and sigma C. Also, we know that there is no state of stress in Z direction. So the principal stress along the Z direction, sigma C will be equal to zero. But we have to find sigma A and B. How we can find sigma A and sigma B? For that, we will need principal angle of principal stresses, and also you will have to find the radius. Clear? Again, because let me delete extra things so that I can easily manage it on the slide. So again, from our trigonometric ratio, you can see that this sigma A is equal to OA plus CA. OA plus CA. And again, OA is sigma average and CA is radius. Clear? So we have sigma A, but we do not have radius. Similarly, sigma B is equal to OB, which is equal to sigma B is equal to OB, which is equal to OC minus CB. Clear? And CB is the radius and OC is average. So sigma average minus R. Clear? So we have calculated sigma average, that is also given over here. We do not know R. Now you can see, if you project this point, so this, let this point is F. So this is FX and this is CF. Clear? So by using Pythagoras theorem, this CX is equal to R. So CX is equal to R. And you can see that this is equal to under the root. If you take the under root, so this will be equal to CF square plus FX square. Clear? Now CF, the value of CF. So this is CF. Again, you can see that at this point, X is C. Clear? So this distance is 6. Clear? And from this point to this point, this distance is sigma average, which is equal to 4.75. So if you subtract 4.75 from 6, so it will be 1.25. Clear? So CX will be this distance, this CX will be equal to 1.25. Clear? This is the CF. Let me clear it. CF. This is CF. CF is equal to CF square. Sorry. This is CX. Clear? This is CX and this is CF whole square plus FX whole square. So CF is equal to 1.25, and this, you can see from this point to this point, this vertical coordinate is 3. So FX is equal to 3. So if you calculate it, the radius comes out to be 3.25. Clear? Now you have radius as well. So if add sigma average with radius will give you sigma A, and if you subtract R from sigma average, so it will be sigma B. Clear? And sigma C is also 0. Clear? Okay. So let me check. Let's move further. Clear? Now you can see here that sigma A is equal to OA. Clear? Sigma A is equal to OA, which is equal to OC plus Ca, OC plus Ca. You have OC, which is sigma average, and Ca, which is radius. We have both the value, sigma average or OC is 4.75, and Ca is radius, which is 3.25. So sigma A is equal to our principal stress is 8. Our maximum normal stress is 8 KSI. Similarly, sigma B is equal to OB, which is equal to OC minus BC. So OC is sigma average and BC is radius. So if you calculate it, sigma B is 1.50. Also, there is no stress in Z direction. So principal stresses along Z direction will be equal to 0. So this is one of the portion of part first. Now you have been asked to calculate theta P, principal plane. Clear? So you, again, this is the initial state of stress CXY or XCY. So if we want to have principal stresses, so we need the principal plane. This is 2 theta P. Clear? So you have to find this. Again, you can find it, this angle, and this angle is equal to tangent of 2 theta P is equal to Fx over CF. Clear? And theta P is equal to 2 theta P is equal to tangent inverse of Fx is 3 and CF is equal to 1.25. So if you calculate it, this tangent of 2 theta P or this 2 theta P angle comes out to be 67.4. So this angle is 67.4. But if you want to represent on element, so it will, theta will be divided by 2 and this will be 33.7. Also, you can say that you have to rotate the element in clockwise direction, in this direction, in order to bring it on the principal plane. Clear? So theta P is 33.7 clockwise direction. So you can see this was initial axis and this is rotated at angle of theta P, and we have represented the normal stresses, principal stresses. So in this direction it is 8, clear, and in this y direction, which is now transformed, that is principal stress is 1.50. So this was the part first, in which we calculated sigma A, sigma B and sigma C and principal plane. Now we will move toward the second part, and that is to find out the normal shear stress, maximum shear stress. So again, if you look, that this is sigma A and this is sigma B, and let this point is, this is the point where, okay, so this is the point or zero point, and there is no normal stress or principal stress in Z direction. So this will be the point C. So if you draw a dotted Mohr circle, clear, and again you have to draw a Mohr circle between point A and C as well. Clear? So let me draw it as well. Now in this condition, you can see the maximum shearing stress will be this one. Clear? But this is maximum shearing stress, and that is out of plane. Clear? So if you want to calculate this maximum shear stress for out of plane, clear, out plane, so that will be equal to sigma a divided by 2, half of the sigma a. Clear? But if you have been asked to find the maximum shear stress for in plane, so for in plane it will be this one, and this term x for in plane that will be equal to sigma a minus sigma b divided by 2. Sigma a minus sigma b divided by 2. Clear? So let's check it. So you can see this is the same thing. This solid circle was the initial, this solid circle was the plane state of stress that was given, and sigma C is equal to 0, so you have drawn a dotted circle, and between B and O, and then you have drawn a dotted circle. So this, so this is your maximum shear stress, and that is out of plane. So if you have been asked the maximum shear stress, so this maximum shear stress is equal to half of sigma A divided by 2, because sigma C is equal to 0. Clear? So this is out of plane shear stress. Again, if you required maximum shear stress in plane, so that will be equal to half of sigma A minus sigma B there divided by 2. That will be in plane shear stress. I hope you have enjoyed video. In our next part of chapter number 7, we will discuss failure criteria. We will discuss yield failure criteria for the ductile material as well as brittle material, and then we applied this knowledge in order to find that whether a material fails or not. So stay tuned to my channel and watch the lectures. Thank you.